All right, Cincinnati 3 Sports, back with another one. Off work today, you know, just chilling. You know, thought I might as well do a couple more videos today, so I'm a little bit more active. But, yeah, I was on YouTube, you know, checking out a couple videos, and I checked out this video about this former NBA player from, you know, the early 90s named Mahmoud Abdul-Rauf. You know, I might have botched his name up a little bit, but hey, you know, it happens. But anyway, you know, they calling him, you know, Steph Curry before Steph Curry, and you know, he was a great shooter, one of the first, you know, shoot first point guards, was the leading scorer, leading assist maker for the Nuggets, you know, back in the early 90s. Got drafted in 1990, the third pick overall, and you know, he converted to Islam, and he felt like the national anthem represented oppression, you know, and I agree with him, you know, and he decided to sit for the national anthem. So the way he said it, you know, he would protest in his own way, you know, instead of standing for the national anthem, he would, you know, do things like stretching and different things, and sometimes he just sit down. You know, he wasn't doing it to be noticed. He was just doing it because, you know, deep down in his heart, you know, he felt like it was oppression. So one day, you know, a reporter, you know, asked him about it, and you know, he went ahead and just, you know, told him how he felt that, you know, the national anthem represented oppression, and you know, how he didn't want to stand for it. And you know, the NBA got wind of this and suspended him for a game because, you know, I didn't notice at the time, it could still be the same today. The NBA had a rule that, you know, all players and coaches and staff have to stand for the national anthem. So he was suspended for that. He ended up coming back and he decided to do his own, you know, you got to call it, you know, a compromise, I guess, you know. And he decided to pray during the national anthem instead of, you know, just sitting down for it. And that's crazy. How can you force somebody to stand up for the anthem, you know, in a league, in a country that's, you know, just based on, you know, freedom of religion and, you know, freedom of speech and, you know, freedom to protest and all this. And they got a rule like that. So, you know, I'm just sitting here like, how is this not, you know, front page? How are they not, you know, asking the commissioner and all these people, you know, what is this about? You know, does this rule still exist? Like, that's crazy. You know, everybody jumping on the NFL, which is, you know, fucked up that Colin Kaepernick's being blackballed, but you got, you know, another league that's basically, you know, feel the same way, you know? So, man, like, it's crazy. So, you know, after he came back, he was the leading scorer, leading assist maker on the Nuggets, you know, and they trade him, you know, the next season. You know, you trade your leading scorer and leading assist maker the next season. You know, well, that's unheard of. So then he went to, you know, Sacramento, you know, injuries plagued him, got limited minutes, and, you know, he didn't play in the NBA anymore. He had to play overseas, you know. I don't see how this isn't being talked about more, man. You know, for all the guys out in the LDBC, YTBC, or anybody who just listen to this and make videos on social topics, man, we need to get the word out on this story, and you know, the NBA need to answer for this. You know, like, I don't see how, you know, this hasn't been brought up. You know, it don't make sense at all. This dude was blackballed, you know, suspended for not standing for the anthem, man. That's crazy. You know, it don't make sense, man. But I'm gonna put a link in the description of a couple videos that I watched about the topic, and you know, y'all let me know how y'all feel about this. Like, comment, subscribe. Make sure y'all hit that bell icon. And you know, that's all I got.